Hi guys, I'm Phil Town from Rule One Investing, and today we're going to talk about what you should do if it looks like you're losing money on your investments. So Warren Buffett says there's only two rules of investing. You guys probably already know this. Rule number one is don't lose money. And rule number two is don't forget rule number one. So what should you do if it appears you're losing money on your investment? What? How does that fit into this thing? And by the way, let me throw in one more little thing here. And that is that Warren also says that you should be comfortable buying into a company and having it go down by 50%. So doesn't that seem to contradict the don't lose money thing? So when you're investing, this is like a really scary thing to see the stock you put money in that you thought you got on a big margin of safety. It just goes down and you start losing money. That's what they would call it in efficient market theory, right? Because in efficient market theory, which is the predominant theory of finance where they teach it in the Ivy League, if the stock goes down, it's because it's worth less than it used to be when you bought it. All right, so that's very scary, right? Stocks go down, their price and their value are the same thing. If it goes down, you've lost because now it's worth less than it was when you bought it. We don't believe any such thing. We don't believe that price and value are the same thing at all. That's extremely important to understand this apparent contradiction between rule number one from Warren Buffett, don't lose money, and his statement that you have to be comfortable watching the stock price go down. How can you have both of those? Well, it's because value is different than price. So what we buy is value. You know, we just paid a certain price for it. Price is just what you pay. Value is what you got. So let's be sure we understand the difference here. It is really important to understand that difference, because if you're into not violating rule number one, and that's what we're all into, then you're going to be sure that you understand the value of your business before you buy it. To understand the value of that business before you buy it, you're going to need to know it's going to be around a long period of time. You've got a really good moat that protects it, and it's going to be worth more in 10 years. And for that reason, you're willing to pay a certain price for that company. Now, we want to pay a price that's a 50% discount to the intrinsic value of the business, what it's really worth. We want to buy it for about half of that. So we're going to have to buy it when there's some sort of major market shakedown, right? When some event happens that puts this thing on sale. If we do that, we are able to buy with a margin of safety, and indeed this company is going to be worth more in 10 years, it's going to be more productive, we're not going to violate rule number one. So we've got to understand the difference between price and value. In fact, we have to understand it so much that if we were to say, do we want the stock price to go up after we buy it, or do we want it to go down after we buy it? We would actually argue we'd rather have the stock price go down. That's because if we did our job, the value's not going anywhere. Value of the company doesn't dip around every 3 days, right? It is what it is. It's going to be bigger in 10 years, so it's going to be more valuable. All right, so the value's not going anywhere, just the price. And if the price is going down, what that means is I'm going to be buying it cheaper in the future. That's awesome, as long as the value stays good. So think about it like this. If I were to just say, let's say I'll offer you up a $100 bill for $100, then when you buy that $100 from me and it starts to go down, you might be concerned about whether or not it's going to be worth it. Maybe inflation is reducing the value of the dollar or whatever, right? On the other hand, if you paid me $50 for that, you have this great big margin of safety. All right, now you got a big cushion. Not only that, but if you paid me $50 for the first $100 bill, and then I offered you the next one for $20, wouldn't you be pretty excited? You're getting enormous value for even cheaper than you got it the first time. So for rule one investors, for Warren Buffett, for Charlie Munger, what we love to see is that we buy a company, we know the value is going to be there in the long run, and the price goes down from where we already bought it on a margin of safety. Now we're buying it for an even bigger margin of safety for an even larger rate of return down the road. So this is how we think about it, you guys. Rule number one, don't lose money. And we're just gonna follow through an understanding that we're not losing money if our value stays solid. Price is just what you pay. And we love to pay the lowest price possible. Now, just in case you're not really sure you get that, think about it like this. Let's say you're gonna go out and buy gasoline for a long time in the future and for your car. We're not all the way to electric cars yet. So let's say we're gonna buy gasoline. And now the price of gasoline is $2.50 a gallon. Okay, well, do you want the price of gasoline to go up or down? You're a consumer. What do you want? You want the price of gasoline to be $4 next week? Or would you rather have it be $1.50? Obviously, you'd rather have it go down than up. That's how I want you to think about pricing in companies. You know you've got a great value. You want the price in the future to go down, not up. Why? Because you're a consumer of stocks right now. You're not ready to retire. We want to buy them cheap. They'll go up in the future if you got the value right. Let the market do its work. It fluctuates. You buy them when they're cheap. If you fluctuate some more, you buy them when they're cheaper. Ultimately, the market will price those back at their value and you're going to make a great return. That's how we handle it. Now, I'd love to hear from you guys. Have you ever, quote, lost money on investment where it just stayed down? Or did it just go down and then go back up? And what did you do about it when it started to go down? Did you blast out of there? Or did you just say, hey, this is a great company, it's gonna come back? So leave a comment below with your answer and I'll be sure to follow up with you. Thanks for watching, you guys. Now go play. If you enjoyed this video and you feel it was valuable in teaching you more about how to think in terms of price and value while you're investing, hit the like button and please share this video with your friends. And if you want more investing content, subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click the button on the screen for a free gift. And thanks again for watching.